Hello everybody, my name is Sam K, and welcome to Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2 The Sith Lords with the restored content mod. Now, as you guys may know, if you follow me on Twitter, you'll know about this. The original Knights of the Old Republic is having issues. I cannot put it at 1080p right now. I don't know why. Yes, I am sick, by the way. I don't know why I can't put it at 1080p right now, but I figured that I needed to get some Star Wars out because Star Wars is something that I love to do on my channel. So I decided to just go ahead and move forward because Knights of the Republic 2 has been updated it got updated so it could run. Let's just go into the options here. As you can see, it's naturally running in 1080p. It's picking up my controller right now as well. So that's pretty interesting. I might have to do something about that in a sec. Turn on soft shadows. I can turn on these frame buffer effects and soft shadows without the game crashing, which is an issue before and still an issue with the original Knights of the Republic. But yeah, you can use controller now, all that kind of stuff. It's pretty cool. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and disconnect my Xbox controller real quick. I think I was playing it for the Ables. And go and just start this game up. Alright. We are back. And it is now unplugged. So yeah, let's just jump right into this game. This game has been known for being buggy and kind of... but it got fixed in the patch that they released. So I'm hoping a lot that the game will be a lot different now. Now, if you guys don't know, I usually play as a guardian, and because I'm not the kind to sneak around, to be honest. And whenever I played World of Warcraft, I would be the guy that would be the sword fighter and stuff like that. I played a Retribution Paladin, a Frost Death Knight, and a Warrior. Those are my three top guys in World of Warcraft. So I'm typically used to being kind of the melee fighter, the attacking a lot of stuff, but I'm wasting your guys' time, aren't I? Let's just jump in. You guys don't want to hear me talk anymore. Let's just go ahead and start creating our character. Now I always do custom character because, you know, I'm custom. let's see. Now I think I have a couple mods on here. I can't really remember too much. The one I know I have is the restored content mod because it you're supposed to have it with the newest patch. It kind of comes with it. So I don't know what other mods I have. I think I have maybe some extra lightsaber hilts it's mainly cosmetics from what I remember installing. Now, I don't like any of my skills to have negative, so I always just put them up to 10 so that it has this little thing right here, even if I don't up them anymore. Since I'm doing a guardian, I wanted a little bit of strength. If you guys don't know, this game kind of uses the D20 rule, which is something that was employed by... Dungeons and Dragons. So you basically roll for what you want, and you get a lot of stuff. Obviously, you can tell I put 15, 15, and 15. Those are the three main skills I want to go for. I might put more into Constitution a little bit later on, but actually, you know what? I'll go ahead and put some into Constitution. Actually, take a little bit away from that. There we go. All right. That way I have a little bit of constitution, I have a little bit more health. So yeah. Oh wait, I have two remaining points. There we go. 14, 15, 14, and 14. So that's pretty good. All right. Get some persuade, because persuasion is something that's very important in this game. Plus, it's something that our character specializes in, because if it's red light or kind of orangish red like this, it means that the character specializes in it. If it's kind of green or I guess you could consider grayed out like that, your character does not specialize in it. So I put a lot into persuade, as you could see. I'm put some into treat injury, a little bit into repair, some into security, even though I don't specialize in either of those, and I'm gonna put the rest into my other two top things. So now we get to the feats. I've realized I'm being very informative on this Let's Play. I wasn't with the Knights of the Republic original, so I think I'm kind of like just kind of making up for it. And plus, I love this series. Knights of the Republic 2 is not my favorite game in the world, don't get me wrong, because I had bad experiences with it, because as I was growing up, it was still buggy, it was still glitchy, and it was unfinished. That's the whole point, it was unfinished, and that's kind of what many people attribute to why people look down on the game. It's not a bad game by any means. It's actually a very good game, and the story actually is somewhat better than the original game. People have drawn comparisons saying, like, it's much darker, much more gritty, but the game itself was unfinished, and it caused it to kind of get that slander slapped on it. But anyway, I will shut up right now. Okay, so as you could see, there's some shit going down on here. Now, this is the prologue. Usually, if I'm playing by myself, I will skip this part because I already know how to play the games. I've played them for years, like literally. Whenever I first played the original, I think it was back in 2005 or something like that. Yeah, like around the time of YouTube's conception, really. So I've played these games for years, so I obviously already know, but since it's a Let's Play, I might as well play it so you guys can see everything that this game has to offer. And my guy is making a retarded face. Look at that face. It's like, hey girl. Oh, well, it went away. But it was like, hey girl, what the fuck?
And that of the Ebon Hawk depend upon.
Well, I kind of look like I'm having a bad time there.
Return to this location at any time to skip the prologue.
I love how it says up here, it says Sam K has fate and that of the Ebon Hawk depend on T3M4 lone Astromech droid. But whenever she's saying it, she says you. instead of Sam K. It's pretty funny. Okay, continue with the prologue.
Press W-A-S. You have me a quest. To hear your quest, this room can...
Okay, go over here. Slice into the system, but I don't have any spikes, so you can just go over here to this plasteel cylinder. Cylinder. And just grab those spikes. And boop. Slice into the system, and then you can open up that door where all that steam's coming out. Oh, gorgeous steam. Thou art a royal bastard. There's a security console, broken droid. Let's go over to the broken droid, get the parts from that. This footlocker. You're supposed to hit it open, but
this old woman appears to be dead.
I don't remember if you get any spikes later on. Or any spikes really. As you guys can hear right there, there was obviously a banging of some sort. So yeah. But I also can't get in there.
If you need help exploring the Oven Hog, access the map screen.
Okay, so I'm gonna open up a couple doors. I'm gonna go back here and I'm gonna try security on this.
Your security skill is too low to open this footlocker. However, you can use your weapon to bash it open. Click on the bash icon or press 1.
Okay, so you can either press 1. I don't know what it is on the Xbox controller, but you can press 1 or click on it. I'm just going to press 1 and bash this fucking thing open. Come on, open up. Knock, knock, motherfucker. Broken item,
sometimes
computer part,
or computers. Container will break some of the items in the container.
Computer spike. I can't say it apparently.
This blast door is magnetically sealed and cannot be opened.
Well, that sucks.
You can hear a banging noise coming from the other side of the door to the storage compartment, but the door is sealed shut. This lift will take you to the outer hull of the Ebon Hawk, where you will find many parts and lines to use for accessing and repairing the hyperdrive. Use the lift controls to go up.
Well, we can't do that just yet, so...
This door is damaged.
Okay, so the door is damaged and we need to do stuff for it. Firstly, though, we need to go over here. That steam is very loud. It's hurting my ears.
Talking to other characters is much like using the computer console in the cockpit. Scroll through your response options or
I'm turning down the knob on my Yeti so that I don't have to hear it's not as loud as for me guys.
How other characters react to you. So choose carefully. Furthermore, certain skills, powers, and attributes may modify what choices you have or how successful you are with those choices.
So basically what she was saying is that depending on what skills you put your stuff into, you can be more or less successful based on those skills when talking. Okay, repair.
Success. You have fixed 3 CFD. Now he will join your party.
Sweet. I still look fucked up though. Invite the C3FD. Deet. I love how Astromech droids talk. It's a bunch of beeps and bloops and stuff.
Later, when you have more companions, you can add and remove
droid impact armor, Mark 1. So, security tunneler is basically make it to where you can open up almost any lock without having to bash it open. Which is pretty awesome, in my opinion. So, yay. Alright, let's open up this guy, too. Field survivor pistol. Yeah, you can get a couple field survivor pistols.
Sensor droids emerge from
I don't think there's a limit on how many, unless they
these
fix that.
Will make for excellent target practice. Use the weapon from this container to attack the droids.
You can get a couple.
You can equip a weapon from the equip screen.
Okay, I think they fixed it. Used to be able to get a ton of field survival pistols from that container, but I guess they fixed it. Anyway, let's shoot these bitches up. Okay, so okay, there's a blast door there. I need to find something to heal T3 and 4. Or is that his name? I can't remember. Yeah, I actually did. T3 and 4.
This is the medical room.
Let's try opening it with that. Yeah, we got it.
You have found med packs. Can use one to stabilize the condition of the human lying on the bed.
The human, not you.
The med pack can stabilize your condition.
Yeah, see, Sam K's condition, but she said your condition.
Success. You are stabilized. To recover fully, you will require the medical facilities at the Paragus mining station. But you are not in any danger of dying from your wounds right now.
Okay, I want to know what wounds my character has contracted to be in a condition where I needed a med pack in order to not die from them. I want to know. I seriously do.
You can use this
if you guys have any ideas, please type them down in the comments, because I'd be genuinely curious. And I have the hiccups like there's no fucking tomorrow, dude. But I'd be genuinely curious. Okay, I think one of the mods I have, it has to do with this right here. Because it looks like there's way more stars in the sky than usually there are. As well as... Yeah, Paragus and these asteroids are actually three-dimensional objects. Or no, is Paragus three-dimensional here? I don't know. But these asteroids are three-dimensional. In the original game, the asteroids are not three-dimensional. They're two-dimensional sprites.
This busted engine board has some needed parts for the Ebonhawk's hyperdrive. The parts here are below. These exposed wires control the door to the starboard dormitory. The door is currently sealed, but you can override it from here.
Okay, so I'm not going to do that because you can do it another way, basically. But yeah, those are usually two-dimensional sprites. But I installed a mod to make them three-dimensional because this was made at a time where computers would have a hernia if they had this many three-dimensional objects in one scene. But now we have games like Grand Theft Auto 5.
Don't forget to this is the port. The bubbles ahead indicate
this is like nothing for computers.
With your awareness skill. Some mines require higher awareness to detect. Approach mines carefully. They will blow up and damage you if you get too close. Can use your demolition skill to either disable or recover these mines.
Okay.
Recovering mines requires a higher demolition skill than disabling them, but you get to keep the mine, which you can then use to set as a trap for enemies or break down into components at a workbench.
Alright, so she was basically telling us how to get these mines. It's not too hard. You just have to have a decent demolition skill. Basically, just I think like two is like, or no, I'm sorry. I think like four is the highest you need for like a deadly mine, which is like the highest grade of mine. So it's not that difficult, to be honest. But anyway, Did I get everything up here? I think I did. Let's go ahead and use the lift controller to go down more. Go inside. Okay. So one thing you can do as T3 and 4 is that you can place mines and it'll blow open doors. Like that. But first, I am going to turn on solo mode. Slice the system. Actually, let me move T3 and 4 over here. Okay, now. Okay, open. Close outer garage door. And open the inner garage door. And log out. And there's another blast door. Can't really go many places here, except for this workbench.
With the workbench, you can break down objects in your inventory into components. You can then use the components to create repair kits, weapons, armor, and upgrades. Because of the damage to the Ebon Hawk, this workbench has limited functionality. You can still use it to create a repair kit, which you can use to repair yourself. Use the workbench to break down the items you've found into components. Then use the components to create a repair kit.
Okay, so we're going to create a repair kit for T3 and 4 so that he can repair himself. So, let's do that. And there we go. He is now repaired. So he's no longer getting that shit done to him to where he's just like having a seizure and just being I'm in pain, kill me. So yeah. Anyway, I'll go ahead and turn solo mode off. That steam is still very loud.
This is the engine room. The starboard engine is badly damaged. Fixing it won't be possible until after docking with the Paragus mining station.
Alright, so that sucks for us.
The port engine is shut down, but appears intact. Fixing the hyperdrive will allow you to restore power to the port engine and bring primary power online.
So yeah, the port engine is perfectly fine, as you can see. But this starboard engine, pretty fucked, as you can tell. The hyperdrive is a little fucked, but it can be fixed.
The hyperdrive is suffering badly. You won't be able to make the jump to light speed until it is fully repaired, and you do not have the needed equipment here on the Ebon Hawk. However, you should be able to rig the hyperdrive to restore primary power and bring the port engine online. This will allow you to dock with the Paragus mining station for full repairs.
Alright, so we're gonna rig up the hyperdrive using five repair parts.
The hyperdrive is online. Primary power is restored. Only one step remains. Return to the galaxy map in the cockpit and travel to Paragus.
Okay, so we need to go to the galaxy map, which is in the cockpit. Yeah, the cockpit. And we can go to the first part, which is Paragus.
Paragus mining station. To dock with Paragus, left click on the Paragus planet to select it, and then left click on the travel button.
Paragus 2.
someone or something else alive on the Ebon Hawk.
What the hell? He went right into the wall. So we are in, if you guys don't know what these are called Colto tanks. Now, what Colto tanks are, they're basically kind of the form of a medicine in Star Wars. If you've ever seen The Empire Strikes Back, that's what Luke is in. Towards the very, after getting saved, that's what he's floating in. So yeah. Now, usually, I don't know why our character didn't. I'm gonna say this before I go ahead and end this episode. That you're supposed to have these kind of masks on. It helps you breathe. I don't know why our character wasn't wearing one. That's a little weird. But anyway, I'm not gonna get into Paragus this level because this has been a long episode, and Paragus is a huge episode that I'll have to do. So anyway, thank you everybody so much for watching. I hope that you liked this video. If you did, please give it a big thumbs up. If you want to see more, make sure to subscribe. Check out all some content I create, and I will see you all in the next video. Bye-bye. Come and get it.